next piece is called Rise of the Ancients. This is a piece that's new to the art number. This is actually a new piece. Conducting Rise of the Ancients, which is Miss Courtney Simi-san. She has been student teaching with me since mid-March. She just graduated last week from Miami University.
Thank you. He asked if we were staying for the rest of the song.
Auditorium, no.
Yeah.
We thought about having concerts at, we thought about renting out like Wes Carrollton's, and that would make people completely outraged. And then we would get one built because, you know, we couldn't go to Wes Carrollton, you know. But they have a nice one, so I was like, I'll play there, let's go. So. You too? See you guys. How are you doing?
Have a good rest of the year. Summer.
3 weeks, baby. A little less. See you again.
Yeah.
I don't ever get to see her anymore because, like, you know, I don't have, I'm not with this group at all. So, bye. Good to see you.
Yeah.
about done?
Yeah, you're about done.
With?
This?
The year.
The year.
I mean...
I'm done.
You're done?
Not good.
I've mentally tapped out.
Yeah, probably pretty... Yeah.
Babysitting three kids two times a week, I'm mentally checked out. Mm.
Yeah. Gotta do it.
Yeah. And sleeping. Mentally checked out.
Well, things will relax a little bit about after this week, so that'll be nice.
Hopefully. Got the banquet next week.
We do. That's going to be a fun night, though. I'm excited for that. Mr. Paul? Mr. Hiram over there? How are we doing?
Yeah.
too.
Thank you.
this kid. You know, man.
Thank you. I transition, just kind of split it. So these students are the second period Carrollton band, so it's really the premier performance of that ensemble under its name. We did a live stream back in November, but we're thrilled to play for you here tonight. These students, I cannot say enough about them. We see them every morning at about like 8:15, and they're still like actually cordial and pleasant, as hard as that might be to believe. I know, I fully understand because you live with them. So you believe it or not, they really are moderately pleasant to be around at that early in the morning. But no, they've done an absolutely amazing job. It's also been a great experience. I've enjoyed this past semester because I have had the opportunity to work with the young man who's actually going to conduct these students tonight. He deserves a medal of honor because he has been forced to spend since January every day with me, and he has somehow survived to tell the story. And last week he graduated with a degree from Miami University.
Movement, so I have to I
Yeah, that link will stay up. We send it, like, it's on our social media. The kids have it on their Google Classroom. We can send it out through email. Understood? Yeah, absolutely. Yeah, it'll stay up, like, it'll be up there. You'll have to, like, you know, find his time. Like, you'll have to scroll to his time, which will be about an hour in. I started it just before 5:30, so scroll to about an hour in. Okay.
Alright. Let's do this.
Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you.
portion of tonight's concert, of tonight's live band concert. collection. For many years, music has been an old dead guy art. All right, let's play some music by old dead guys. All right, so this part is really fun because we get to play music by women. Who knew? Right? So this is really exciting. We get to have some representation in our program. We have a lot of fine young women up here in our ensemble, and so it's nice to sort of represent a little bit of them. We believe in that pretty strongly here. So that's a lot of fun. This next piece, it sort of depicts a Japanese folktale about two stars that live far apart from each other in the sky, and they can pass, but they can never quite meet. And I think you'll hear kind of that longing and that heartbreak. This is Yukiko Nishimura's Starship.
Thank you.
candlelight setting of the music, and then we're gonna twist it around, turn it upside down, do a couple different things with it. So there's three variations. See if you can kind of hear where they start and stop. Mark Williams, variance on a nautical air. After we go first pick.
Thank you. up here.
Thank you.
Thank you. that I obviously have it at the concert, but I have to do it regularly.
Thank you.
again with special district seniors here. These guys have dealt with, I know parents who understand what they've dealt with, just to get to this moment. So we are thrilled to perform for you. We are the Miami Professional Wind Symphony. We picked out a music, a program of music that we think you're going to enjoy. It's going to be a lot of fun. It's really challenging on these guys. We've really pushed them a lot. So we hope you enjoy to get started. As a fanfare by American composer Jack Stamp. He's known for really fast, energetic music that involves a lot of repetitions, and you hear a lot of that. And a lot of his music blink and you might miss it. This is one of those. So this is Jack Stamp's The Wharton Fanfare. Thank you. and like 99.9% of the time, an arranger takes the piece and makes it much easier and much more manageable for the students to play. This is not one of those. This is, they took the original orchestra version and dropped it for band. So this is like the professional version that you would hear in the movie, just with different instruments, all right? It is not really watered down at all, which you'll hear really quick, because this is not easy. So I hope you enjoy John Williams' The Cowboys. sweat like crazy and all that. I explain my arts. All right. We're going to move on now to something completely different. Eric Whitaker writes a lot of music for the band. If you were around a couple years ago, we played a piece of his called Godzilla Eats Las Vegas. There's a whole script about Godzilla destroying the city of Las Vegas. This piece is nothing like that at all. But it's one of the prettiest pieces I think ever written for a band. It's just absolutely really pretty. And we like writing and playing pretty music. So we hope you enjoy Eric Whitaker's October. Thank you. turning away the Ohio Music Education Association did a virtual adjudication event this year, something they haven't done in ever. And if you should do it first, no, we haven't done it in many, many years. But kind of on a whim, we recorded this piece a couple weeks ago. We just sent it away, and we got a superior rating. So hi.
Thank you.
been a long day. We would love to be able to go home. So if you could give us like 10 minutes of your time, we would be eternally grateful. Please help us. All right, I promise you a little emotional here as we get to our last two. Because I didn't get to do this last year. I tell this story every year. I'm going to tell it every year for at least 20 more years until I retire and you all get rid of me. Years and years ago, we finished the spring concert. I was directing the symphonic band at the time. And my mom was at the concert. My mom has been here for over 4 hours. Like, she's right up here at the top. I love your mom.
You too, buddy.
Yeah.